Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Shannon. If you are new here, well, this topic came up as I was talking to various people at various times over the past couple of months, and I noticed that every time I said this particular attribute, people were like, oh, I never thought of that. So some people were married, some of my friends who I talked to were single, but every single person had the deer in the headlight look when I mentioned this. And so I was thinking to myself, well, you know what? I really haven't heard this subject talked about in the pulpit when ministers talk about marriage and what to plan for. I haven't heard it in any of the chats or any of the, you know, discussions. So I was like, yeah, people really are not talking about this. And I think that it is absolutely so imperative for a guy, a man, the person that you are going to marry, to have this attribute. I'm telling you, I have seen marriages dissolve because the man was not flowing in this attribute. I have seen and know of women who have been emotionally crushed because the man that they married did not have this attribute. And so I'm not just kind of like off the top of my head thinking about this. I have seen what has occurred when healthy marriages have this attribute and the man has this attribute. And so I am going to go ahead and get into it. So what am I talking about? What is the topic? What is that attribute that you want to make sure that every single man that you would even consider for marriage has? That is the desire and also the willingness to have someone that they are accountable to. Now, when I'm talking about accountability, I'm not talking about their brother, their best friend. I'm talking about somebody who is more seasoned than them. I'm talking about somebody who has a good track record, someone with integrity, somebody with wisdom, somebody who can tell them, listen, bro, you know what you're doing? You're not right. This is wrong. You shouldn't be doing that. And even though I'm talking about the men who we would consider for marriage, this also goes for women. I think that every single person needs to have at least one seasoned, wise person who will be someone that they can be accountable to. And whether or not you're a male or a female, it doesn't matter. But it is imperative that the male, the husband to be, or your husband, have this character trait because he's the head. And so if there is something that is going on in your marriage and you are not getting his ear as it relates to a concern that you have, and I'm not talking about petty stuff, I'm not talking about things, the day-to-day mundane, I'm talking about like high level stuff where it's really gonna turn into a situation if it's not dealt with, right? And so if he has blocked you out and he doesn't want to talk to you or whatever, there has got to be somebody in his life who he is accountable to, who you can go to and say, listen, I don't know what to do. I don't know what's going on, but you know, I've tried. Can you help me out? Can you give me some insight? Am I right? Am I wrong? Am I this? Am I that? And, you know, when we have that accountability, it's not about, you know, people getting into our business. It's not about, oh my gosh, well, I want to maintain my privacy and all this other stuff. It's about safety and support, because transparency and accountability automatically bring safety and support. And when you are about to go into a covenant with a person, and they are not humbled enough to say, you know what, there are times where I know I don't see things the right way, or there are times when maybe I might need to be checked. Listen, we all need to be checked. Nobody's right all the time. And I'm glad I have people in my life who not only check me, some of them enjoy checking me. But we all need people who are gonna do that. And you guys, a man who no one could correct, a man who thinks they know it all, a man who does not listen to the wise counsel of other people, is a very dangerous man, okay? And you don't want to be yoked to someone who thinks they know it all, who is going to shut the opinions of other people down. Why do I say that? Because that person is not only selfish and self-centered, but you know, the thing about that is that nobody can tell them anything. So they think that they know it all. And that's a level of immaturity, right? Because everybody knows that in life, listen, nobody knows it all. We all have to learn from other people and we have to get counsel from other people in all areas of our life from time to time. And so if you're dealing with somebody who doesn't even respect the opinion of somebody who was wiser, somebody who is more seasoned than them, as it relates to things within a marriage arena, then that's really, really dangerous. And listen, it's only a matter of time before it spirals down. I have never seen a healthy, thriving marriage that has been long-term where somebody has no capacity, ability, or desire to receive counsel from another person outside of the marriage. You know, we evolve as people, and because we evolve as people, it's only natural to think that that marriage is going to evolve as well. And so you need to have, no matter who you are, no matter how wise you are, no matter how much experience you have, no matter all of that stuff, when there are two people, there are two different opinions. And in order to sometimes to bring those two different worlds together, you have to have outside counsel sometimes. It doesn't mean that there is anything wrong. It doesn't mean that there is anything right. But humility and understanding that you're not always going to be right. You're going to be blindsided. You're not going to see things the other way. You're not going to this. You're not going to that. It's just using wisdom. There are people, you know, even in my dating life that I go to and I'm like, listen, this is happening with this guy. I feel like this is going on, but you give me your side. Like, this is what happened. A, B, C, D, E. Tell me what I need to think. Am I being too sensitive? Am I trying to like project too much into this? And I go to the guys who I know, some people in my family, some men who I love, know, and trust, and I know that they'll have the best intentions for my future. And so I go to them. And they are always very honest. And, you know, if I am wrong or they say, you know what, you're being too sensitive, I take that to heart. But if they're like, no, don't deal with that person, or no, don't whatever, I'm like, okay, that's what I was thinking. That's why I wanted to bring it to you. I do this regularly. So accountability and transparency, not only before you get married, but you want to marry somebody who is going to value that when you're married, because you're going to hit some hiccups. You're going to have some speed bumps. You're going to deal with situations as you're evolving in that marriage. And so having that support, being transparent and accountable to, you know, whomever it is, whether or not it's a male, a female, whoever, it's just a protection for you. It's a support and it's a safety. And so when you are considering someone for marriage, you know what? Just pay attention. You don't want to obviously mention this when you first meet someone or when you're just getting to know them or whatnot, but kind of see where their values are as your relationship progresses and develops, and see if it's something that they would value, because this is one of the foundational things, one of the foundational keys, I believe, that, you know, can lead to a very long and happy, successful marriage. And the marriages that I have looked at and that I have seen that are healthy, that, you know, where they still have a really close, loving bond, even though it might not be all romantic and kissy-kissy all the time, you can tell that there's a mutual respect and love for each other. Those are the relationships that I have seen time and time again show that they are willing to be transparent with their stuff. They're willing to allow other people who may be more seasoned or who might have more insight into a situation to give them, you know, their opinion, to give them their counsel. So I had done another video when I first started this channel. Listen, it's not the smoothest one, but it's a pretty good video. Men that you want to avoid when you are, you know, in the dating world or whatever. If you see men with these attributes, run. And so I'm going to link that video up there so that you can take a look at that. So I would love to get your feedback, your comments. Listen, if there are some things that make you kind of look sideways at a person, or maybe there's some attributes that you know you absolutely can't live without in the person that you desire to marry, leave them below. Help us all. I love looking at comments. I love getting feedback. If this was at all helpful, please give me a thumbs up, and I will see you guys on the next video. Bye.